Hey guys, this is Vikas from AirGenius and today I am with a new episode around Raspberry Pi where we will see how to run a Java application in Raspberry Pi. This episode will be all about like how to create an application outside of a Raspberry Pi or like in our workstation and then create an executable file that you can take into Raspberry Pi and run it there. So let's check it out. Let's get started guys. So guys, in this, what we'll be doing is we'll develop our application in our desktop and we'll have an executable file created in our desktop and we'll transfer that particular file to the Raspberry Pi and then run the application in the Raspberry Pi. So to do that, you can use any IDE. Actually, Raspberry Pi supports Eclipse and other IDEs, but it will be like overloading for the Raspberry Pi. So to simplify the process, we'll just compile our application in our desktop and we'll transfer the jar executable file to Raspberry Pi and run it there. But before that, one thing need to be checked is like the JDK version, whatever you are using to compile or create the executable file in your desktop has to be like equal or smaller than the JDK installed on Raspberry Pi. To check the JDK installed on Raspberry Pi, you can simply type in Java certain version. So it says my JDK version on Raspberry Pi is 1.8 and I am compiling my application on desktop using Java 1.7. So it will like work out there. But if it is like higher than the Java installed in Raspberry Pi, it will throw you a major minor exception. So let's create a project using Eclipse. Give it any name. Raspberry Java, I'll give it. Then click on next and finish it. Now let's create a class inside our project. To do that, I'll just create a simple class. This main class. And I'll include the public static void method. Okay, it says default package is discouraged. It's okay because we don't have like many classes. We are just having a single class inside of project. So inside class, let's put a simple statement that prints out hello world. Now run the application in your desktop. To do that, just click this button, or that may change depending upon your ID you are using. And you can see over here it has printed hello world. Now to make executable file out of it, you can just go to export. Over here under Java, select runnable jar file, click on next, and over here on launch configuration, just choose the main class or class with the project name, and over here you can just give it a like destination where it will be exported. So let me do my desktop, like let's say test.java, and over here you can select anything, but I personally prefer the copy required libraries into a subfolder because each time let's say I am using large number of libraries and my jar file gets actually like heavier. So each time I will not have to transfer large files to my Raspberry Pi, which will ultimately take time. So over here, if you are not changing library, you can simply upload the library folder at once. And you can compile and upload your jar file like as you want. And the size will remain pretty small. Now click on finish. So over here, we'll get two things like the jar file, then the lib folder. So as we have not included any library, we'll see empty folder over here. Now, just open up any FTP program to upload the file to the Raspberry Pi using the IP address. Or you can use a pen drive or anything to transfer the files from your desktop to the Raspberry Pi. So, like, let's put my IP of Raspberry Pi. The username before it is Pi. Then Raspberry. One yes. I have personally used WinSCP. You can use any other FTP program. Depend upon what you are comfortable with. And over here, this shows my desktop side and this shows my like Raspberry Pi side. So go to desktop, as we have exported our executable file to the desktop. And just select the jar file as well as the lib folder. And over here you can select the desktop and upload it. So now our exported jar file has got uploaded to the Raspberry Pi desktop. So to check that, just navigate to desktop folder and you can see test.jar and test_lib. Now to run the jar file in your Raspberry Pi, you can simply type in sudo java-jar and the file name. So over you can see it has printed out hello world. That means the file has been successfully run. Now when you change something in your in your project, let's say I have added another line. You don't need to compile it again, or you can just compile it if you want to like test it out on your desktop. And now click on export. The selected runnable jar file will there, like runnable jar file. Click on next, select the launch configuration as earlier, or if you have not changed this, it will be like whatever you selected before, and the destination. Now go to your FTP application, and over here you don't need to put the test lib folder again to the Raspberry Pi because we have already uploaded it once. And if you have not included any library, it is not at all required to upload. So now I'll just upload my test.jar file. Now when I come like run on my Raspberry Pi, you can see it has printed two lines, whatever you were specified in our class file or Java file. So that's all guys, that's all with like using Java in Raspberry Pi. So thank you, thanks for watching.
Hey guys, it's me once again and hope you have liked my video. If so, just hit the thumbs up button. If you don't, there is a thumbs down button for you also. And don't forget to subscribe my channel for latest updates. Okay, see you next time with my new content. That's all guys, thank you, thanks for watching.